That's lost. If we can move to the substantive motion. Can we move on?
I move approval, Chair.
Second. Pat. All those in favour of approval? Against? That's carried, thank you. If we can now move to agenda item 10, which is pages 79 to 86 of your agenda.
Is solving the erection of a bungalow in the garden area of Courtyard House. The proposal seeks consent for a single-storey, three-bedroom property with access via West Grove. The existing dwelling, Courtyard House, would sit significantly higher than the proposed dwelling, sitting some 6 metres above the application site. Adequate separation distances are comfortably achieved in excess of the minimum 21 metres expected, at some 26 metres, ensuring overlooking will not take place. Private garden area is retained for the host dwelling, whilst garden area is also proposed for the new dwelling. Off-street parking is proposed by way of an integral double garage and a private driveway. Conditions are proposed that require additional details regarding drainage, boundary treatment, landscaping and materials to be used in the construction of the development. The construction management plan is also conditioned. Permitted development rights removed relating to extensions and additions. The site is located within Lower Heswall Conservation Area. However, the proposal is not considered to represent any harmful impact on the setting of that conservation area, and the scale and design proposed are considered to be appropriate to the character of the area. Policy HS4 allows new residential development within primary residential areas, and the proposal is considered to be acceptable having regard to the criteria set out within that policy. Development is recommended for approval, and there is no qualifying petition or objection in connection with this application.
Okay, you can see that there's a toward council here, so I will go to the committee.
I move the opposite of the recommendation to somebody else. We've been through this one.
Okay, nobody else wants to speak on that? No. Okay, so I have a mover, do I have a seconder? All those in favour of approval? Unanimous, that's carried, thank you. So if we move to agenda item 12, that's planning applications decided under delegated powers between the 11th of June and the 9th of July. Are we happy to approve those?
Yes.
Okay, if we move to agenda item 13, planning review is decided between the 1st of April and the 13th of June, pages 125 to 132. Are we happy to note those? Sorry?
Just in reference to the appeal.
Miscellaneous provisions, regulations.
2006, which is made under the Housing Act 2004, which specifically require dwellings in multiple occupation where there are five or more occupants for there to be a bathroom and separate toilet. Chair, my view is that we are entitled, the residents are entitled, for inspectors to have regard to the law when making decisions of on planning applications. If you do not know what to submit, good enough for an inspector to lay down his own rule of thumb with regard to where the facility he thinks ought to be appropriate or which are uncommon. If he thinks that they're uncommon, then he ought to bring them to the attention of the appropriate rights authorities so that those HMOs that he's aware of should be shut down. I would submit, Chair, that in setting his own rule of thumb, which is outside the statutory framework, the inspector has erred in law, and therefore we ought really to see redress in High Court and have the decision of the inspector quashed. There's no excuse for the inspector reaching a conclusion on the ratio of facilities without having regard to legislation. Now, other members around the table will be going, oh my God, we can't question these people are gods. However, a number of outstanding members will recall a number of months ago a High Court questioned decision of the Planning Inspector in regards to Bruce Ferry. And we were all quite surprised that one of the grounds given by the High Court was that the inspector did not have due regard to disabled access to the riverfront. Now clearly in that particular case, which we were aware of, that it related to an application that came for our committee, it was clear that the High Court did believe that inspectors should have regard to statutory instruments and any statutory provisions on them to take down. I think, Chair, but I'm not aware, I think we might have good grounds. Finally, Chair, I'm conscious that if we wish to make applications to question the inspector's decision, we would need to do so within 6 weeks of the inspector's letter. The inspector's letter was issued on 27th of June, so that doesn't get us effectively to obviously the end of this month. I would ask the committee, possibly federal officers, to advise the way forward if committee believe that we ought to go down the road of at least seeking the advice of counsel as to the chances of success and to advise us as to where the delegated powers might exist within the organisation, whether that would be with this committee, with the spokespeople, or with the council's cabinet members, so that this matter can be expedited within the 6 week period that we have to consider the grounds for clearing the inspector's decision to that.
Thank you, Stuart. I just want to bring to members' attention that I actually declared an interest in this application when it was first heard, because I knew the lead petitioner. Now, I didn't feel I needed to declare an interest in this instance today, but I just want to seek some clarification really from the solicitors on that point.
I think that the point being raised is a technical legal point, and therefore I think it impacts on, because the decision has been taken by the planning inspector. We're now looking at whether or not there are grounds to and appeal that to the High Court, and I don't think that impacts on your position.
Okay, thank you for clarification.
Councillor Kelly has raised this with me, and I have discussed it with my colleagues in planning. We don't believe that there are grounds for judicially reviewing the decision of the planning inspector in this case. The fact that the licensing regime does not apply to planning and therefore does not impact HS4 and HS14. I know that you refer to the Monks Ferry case, but in the Monks Ferry case this is quite clear that equality issues are something that the planning committee should consider in all their decisions, and that was the reason that was given in relation relation to why that appeal was overturned, the inspector's appeal was overturned. The inspector, the planning inspector, in the absence of any clear policy from Railway Council Planning on HMOs, is able to draw its own conclusions on such matters as ratio of washing facilities to residents. And to be successful in a judicial review, we would have to prove that that not only was unreasonable, but was so unreasonable that no other planning inspector would have reached the same conclusion. And I think in the absence of any clear planning policies from Wirral that set out what our expectations for ratios are within HMOs, I think the chances of success in the judicial review are, you know, quite low. I don't know if there's anything else that the planning officers want to add to that.
Just to add to what the solicitor has said there, we're very conscious that HMOs have been an issue now for some time, both at this committee and also with our housing colleagues. And I've spoken to the Cabinet Member for Housing about these particular issues, and I'll be speaking to him again in the morning. And I think, given all of the issues, what we are going to prioritise with Councillor Davis's support is the swift progression of an SPD on HMOs, and we're going to look at the Housing Act and the standards involved in that. And I've also suggested to Councillor Davis that given there is cross-party interest in these matters, and obviously this is for members to decide, I'm not being prescriptive here, but I've suggested to him that it may be worthwhile looking at having a working group or a task and finish group where all of the issues related to HMOs, I say not just to planning, not just to housing, but obviously not to mention Grenfell tonight, because I'm leading, as you know, on the council's high-rise response, and part of the work around that has also identified we've got lots of HMOs that are in similar